Good evening. Thank you all for joining us. I want to begin with a couple of thank yous. I'm going to go off script right in the very beginning. This is everybody's worst nightmare. But I want to begin with a couple of thank yous. First, I want to thank all of the Midland College faculty and staff who are here this night, who are here with us tonight. And I want to thank those of those who are not here as well for all of the work that they've done over the course of this fall semester and prior semesters to get us to where we are tonight with the ability to celebrate you all. I want to also thank, personally, the Midland College Board of Trustees for giving me an opportunity to do my dream job. Not sure whether or not you know, this is my very first commencement. Thank you. My name is Damon Kennedy, and I have the pleasure of serving as the fifth president of Midland College. And on behalf of the Midland College Board of Trustees, the faculty, staff, and the administration that you see here on the stage and those in the audience, I want to welcome you to Midland College's December 2023 commencement ceremony. In our 50-year history, this is our first December commencement, so you're all firsts. You get to join me in being a first. I want to thank and congratulate also all of you, all of our candidates tonight. Thank you for all of your hard work, all of your dedication, all of your commitment, all of the time that you spent, the energy that you expended to be here and to have this great success. I want to thank you also for making your education a priority, and I want to thank you also for allowing Midland College to be a part of that. We love what we do every day, and the people on your left and right love what they do every day, and we're so proud to be here. The Midland College Board of Trustees also thanks you and congratulates you. The board is the governing body of this institution, and for their vision and leadership, I'd like to ask the members who are here with us tonight to stand so that we can recognize them for their service to our college. Thank you all. You may now be seated. It gives me great pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker and Midland College alumnus, Dr. Brandon Kit Bredemus. I've had the great good fortune of being able to work with Kit over the last several years, and I want to tell you that he is a tremendous asset to our community, and he's a tremendous ambassador and supporter of Midland College. Dr. Bredemus is the Vice President of Nursing and Chief Nursing Officer at Midland Memorial Hospital. In that capacity, he oversees nursing practices at the hospital and ensures services are designed and implemented to meet the needs of patients, medical providers, the community, and also employees. Kit joined Midland Memorial team in 2008 as a staff nurse in the emergency department, and MMH subsequently promoted him to Director of Emergency Services. Since then, Dr. Bredemus has become a nationally recognized leader, named a Modern Healthcare Rising Star in Nursing Award winner, the American Association for Nursing Leadership Early Careerist Award winner, Becker's Rising Star in Healthcare, and a finalist for Nursing Management's Hayter Visionary Nurse Leader Award. Dr. Bredemus holds multiple national board certifications in executive nursing and leadership, and is a distinguished fellow of the American College of Healthcare Executives, the American Organization for Nursing Leadership, and the National Academies of Practice. Dr. Bredemus graduated from Midland High School in 2002 and was in the top 25 of his graduating class. He first attended Midland College while he was in high school, taking certified nurse aide classes, as many of you did in our group of candidates tonight. After high school graduation, he chose to stay in Midland, and he earned an associate degree from Midland College in 2004. He then transferred to Texas Tech and later to the University of Texas Medical Branch at Galveston, where he received a Bachelor of Science degree in nursing. Dr. Brittimus went on to earn a Master's of Science degree in nursing and a Doctorate in Executive Nursing from Texas Tech University Health Science Center in 2021. The Texas Nurses Foundation and Nurse Association recognized him as one of 20 nurses in the state who went above and beyond during the COVID pandemic. I want to first hope that Kit didn't intend to talk about himself because I just stole his entire speech, but I want to also welcome my friend and colleague, Kit Brittimus, to the stage.
All right, no pressure after that, right? So Dr. Kennedy told me just before this that I am the best speaker they've ever had at a fall commencement. Now finding out that this is the first one, so starting off with some humor here. So, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud family members, and of course, most importantly, the distinguished graduates of Midland College. I am honored to celebrate this momentous occasion with you this evening. We are here today to recognize your years of hard work, dedication, and perseverance. As we gather tonight to honor your achievements, it's not just about receiving your degree. It's about acknowledging the challenges that you've faced head on and that the resiliency that you've displayed in being able to walk this stage today. As a native Midlander and alumnus of MC myself, I remember the first time I stepped foot on this campus. Like many of you, I embarked on a journey that was filled with excitement and uncertainty. I had no idea what lay ahead for me, but I knew that education was going to be my best path forward for a better life. For some of you, today is the first step in a well-defined career journey. For others, the path forward is not so clear. I can relate to both. When I graduated from MC, my future was uncertain. I found myself at a crossroads, trying to decide what I wanted to do with my life. It is while I was here at MC, with the help of some caring faculty, that set me on my path and here before you today. Midland College is great because, unlike the major universities, I'm not just one face in an auditorium of 500 people. Here, you get that individualized attention. From the faculty, they get to know you. They get to engage you. You know each other through dialogue and sometimes debate. That's what happened in my U.S. history class with Dr. Houck. I know he's in here somewhere. I saw him earlier today. There he is. All right. He was one of the first educators who recognized that nursing may be an option for me. I had found myself needing some direction, and it was something I hadn't really considered. But he talked me through some options of what is a medical-related field that offered some benefits and good opportunity for growth. I'm thankful for that conversation and my time here at MC, because it helped me build a strong foundation for learning that I need to be open to opportunities that I hadn't previously considered. Although I never aspired to be a nurse, I found my calling in nursing, and it has been my life's work ever since. My journey would take me across the state and several years before moving back home to Midland to start my family. As you heard, I moved my way up from a staff nurse in the emergency department at MMH to becoming a vice president and the chief nursing officer. While I'm proud of my accomplishments and obstacles that we have overcome in the emergency department in my tenure as the director, it would pale in comparison to the trials and tribulations that awaited me as the chief nurse. Within my first 8 months as a CNO, I would have to lead through some of the most traumatic disasters to hit our community and the globe. These were, and still are, some of the most challenging times in my life. But it was in response to those disasters and reflection back on that time that I learned some lessons that I would like to impart with you today. First is that this is a commencement, not a conclusion. We are celebrating not just the culmination of your time here at Midland College, but the future that awaits you as a graduate. Your education does not end after you leave here. Sorry, spoiler alert, sorry, it keeps going. You've learned that success is not just about the destination. It's the journey, the obstacles that you overcome, the good times and the bad, and the growth that occurs along the way. One of my favorite quotes is from Archilochus, in that we do not rise to the level of our expectations, but that we fall to the level of our training. Life is filled with all kinds of twists and turns, but I can tell you that your time here has prepared you for the unexpected. No matter your path, be it formal education in the form of additional coursework or degrees, or experiential learning in the form of on-the-job training and professional development, the work does not stop now. Your degree is the potential. It's up to you to capitalize on that potential and turn it into the outcomes that you started here for. You have the tools to succeed in whatever it is that you choose to do. The mundanity of excellence. One of the most valuable lessons that you've learned here is the importance of hard work. Daniel Chambliss is a sports sociologist who coined the term the mundanity of excellence. In his article, he defined that the athletes that he studied, that excellence is the consistent superiority of performance. And while this can seem unobtainable to us mere mortals, he challenges that achieving excellence is not as impressive as we think. We can all fall in that mental trap that some people achieve success because they have some innate ability, advantage, or they're just plain lucky. And while a myriad of factors make up excellent performance, many are often mistaken and mislabeled as talent. Exceptional people work hard to make excellence look easy. I'm paraphrasing Jefferson here a little bit, but I found in my own career that the harder I worked, the luckier I got. And it's not the heroic lift of major accomplishments. It's the day in and day out work that adds up. The mundanity of excellence is the consistent application of hard work. Small actions done well, consistently. That's it. That's the secret that is to success. Consistency beats intensity every day of the week. So when you look at those who inspire you, it can become easy to envy their success while overlooking the sacrifice that led to it. Persistence in your effort to refine your craft will what make you successful, but it means you have to say no to the distractions and the comforts that are so appealing. Your Midland College education came at a sacrifice to your time, money, pleasures, and comforts, but it has equipped you with the knowledge to recognize that opportunities are revealed through hard work and the ability to seize them. The obstacle is the way. I'm a big fan of Stoic philosophy, especially Marcus Aurelius. As the Emperor of Rome, he faced some challenges. Now, before you make a joke that I'm just another trope of a guy that thinks about the Roman Empire on a daily basis, please hear me out. He experienced war, a plague, revolt, death, betrayal, and disappointment on a scale that's hard to comprehend. One of his most cited meditations is that the impediment to action advances action. What stands in the way becomes the way. Life will present you with challenges that may seem insurmountable at times. I have dedicated my life to those who have experienced unimaginable tragedy and loss. As an ER nurse, foster parent, and advocate, I've seen human suffering that most cannot imagine. But tragedy befalls all of us at some point, and it is in the response to that crisis where our power lies. It is in crisis that character is revealed and not built. If you want to know who someone really is, look how they respond to adversity. It's easy to back down when obstacles appear, to fall into a victim mindset, as the world rewards complicity and negativity. But remember this, we are all called to a greater purpose. We all have something that we were put on this earth to do. I've seen tragedy crafted into purpose. I've seen people hit rock bottom only to soar higher than they ever thought they could. Your trials will introduce you to your strengths, and it will help you discover your passion and your purpose. Fear will try to keep you from your calling, fear of failure, fear of looking foolish, fear of the unknown, and so on. As you move forward, do not be afraid to take risks. Dream big and pursue your goals with tenacity. Be like the fire that grows stronger with everything that's thrown at it. Seek out the path of discomfort, because this means you are growing beyond your current limitations. Finally, and most crucial to remember, is that success is a collaborative effort. There's an African proverb that says, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. You have the support of amazing faculty, fellow alumni, and this community. I still frequently keep in contact with my classmates, faculty, and mentors that I've encountered in my career, and I encourage you all to do the same. They will be the ones to challenge your assumptions and steer you in the right direction when you need guidance. Cherish the relationships that you've built during your time here. The people who have played a significant role in your journey at MC are a source of strength and support through the tough times. In the face of challenges, a supportive tribe can make all the difference. My advocacy during the COVID pandemic was lauded as courageous by some and villainized by others. Many times I felt alone speaking up, in isolation and fear because it was affecting all of us. But I was not out there by myself. I was with the over 2,000 healthcare workers of Midland Health who were working tirelessly to save our patients. They are the true heroes and who I continue to draw my courage from. My wife, Heather, who has been by my side since we were 16 years old. She helped keep our family together while I was working 16-hour days trying to make sure that things were running at the hospital. She even went on to organize Thank a Healthcare Hero events to make sure that we recognized healthcare workers across the Permian Basin. Along the way, we all have someone who has believed in us and gave us a hand up, whether we recognize it or not. Many of those people are here in this room today to celebrate you. I challenge all of you here this evening to be that person who inspires and encourages the next generation. I'm not here on my own account, as my hard work and determination was instilled in me and fostered through caring teachers and colleagues. I stand here today on the shoulders of giants. As you embark on the next chapter of your lives, carry that Midland College spirit with you. Be bold, be brave, be persistent. Never underestimate your ability to succeed through hard work. I live my life by the motto, proceed until apprehended. So those of you that know me, I live it. I live it outright all the time. This credo means that you are all empowered to take control of your lives and the necessary actions to become the best version of yourself. You do not need permission, and you do not need the perfect set of conditions to get started. Don't fear the naysayers and the critics who will lull you into a placid existence. Your education has given you the foundation, but it's your determination and resilience that will propel you forward. In closing, I encourage all of you to be relentless in the pursuit of your dreams. Your life is an adventure, and you write your own story. Congratulations to the Midland College class of 2023. Go Shaps.
Candidates, faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen in the audience, I'd like to ask you to please stand. And gentlemen, remove your hats. And I want to invite Amaya Johnson to the stage for the singing of our national anthem.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. That our flag flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Maya. Thank you, Kit. Midland College is certainly proud to have the both of you with us this evening. You may now all be seated. Thank you. In 1986, the Abel Hanger Foundation created the Abel Hanger Scholarship. The name of the scholarship was changed to the Legacy Scholarship in 2003. And now includes three other local foundations that help with the scholarship funding: the Helen Greathouse Charitable Trust, the Chaparral Foundation, and the Scarborough Foundation. Together, these four organizations now champion a continuing commitment to provide educational opportunities for students throughout this community. There's also a community service component to the scholarship program, and over the past 37 years, Midland College students have contributed approximately 800,000 community volunteer hours at more than 90 Permian Basin nonprofit agencies. Our graduating legacy scholars have maintained their academic standing and completed their volunteer requirements. These students are wearing a green braid as a part of their regalia, and there is a notation beside their name in the printed program. I'd like to ask the legacy scholars to now stand and be recognized. Thank you. Also noted in your programs are members of Midland College's Sigma Kappa Delta English Honor Society. In addition, the program indicates students who are graduating from our honors program. These honors scholars have completed a minimum of 12 hours of honors credit with a partial emphasis in humanities and have maintained a 3.2 GPA. The printed program also notates those students who are members of Phi Theta Kappa, the oldest, largest, and most prestigious honor society servicing two-year colleges around the world. The international organization is composed of over 1,400 chapters, and the Midland College Phi Theta Kappa chapter is rated as a 5-star, which is the highest rating Phi Theta Kappa designates among its member chapters. This past March, the Midland College Chapter Service Project was recognized as the top chapter service project in the state of Texas. Will all of the Sigma Kappa Delta members, honors scholars, and Phi Theta Kappa members please stand and be recognized? Thank you. With us tonight, we also have a group of high school students participating in tonight's ceremony who will be receiving certificates in Health Sciences Foundations and Business Management Foundations. These students are now eligible to continue into advanced certificate programs that lead to Midland College associate's degrees and further rewarding careers. Congratulations to these students who have shown tremendous discipline and perseverance. Please stand as we applaud you for taking the initiative to begin your higher education and career pathways. Thank you. I'd like to also recognize those graduates who are serving and those who have served our country. We especially want to honor our graduating active military and veterans. those men and women who have selflessly given of themselves to defend the United States of America. Please stand so that we can thank you and so that you can also be recognized. Thank you. Now, I would invite Dr. Michael Dixon, Vice President of Instruction, to please come forward.
Dr. Kennedy, members of the board, I present the candidates for graduation from our baccalaureate degree, associate degree, and certificate programs here assembled. Graduates, please come forward as Dr. Jaime Aguila, Professor of History, calls your names. Members of the Board of Trustees will join Dr. Kennedy for the presentations.
Patillo. Shea Crawford. Eniola Odeneyi. Areli Natividad. Precious Bamidele. Viviana Lawal. Allison Alfaro. Adriana Arispe. Marco Armendares. Fabian Avalos. Madison Boozer. Sierra Castillo. Tabor de la O. Evelyn Diaz. Michaela Fisher. Liliana Gonzalez. Priscilla Gonzalez. Sarah Hem. Juan Jaramillo. Natalie Jordan.
Annalise
Loftus. Zachariah Machuca. Thaw Parr. Hannah Sanchez. Heather Snyder. Felicity Taylor. Natalie Taylor. Lal Thang. Seth Vetter. Michael Walton. Cullen Weed. Haley Williams. Arantza Ramirez. Jaden Kuhlman. Andrew Martinez. Zachary Ramirez. Brycey Tamayo. Alina Barron. Abdullahi Job. Alexander Doomer. Sadie Fuentes. Elisette Hinojos Garcia. Casey Martindale. There you go. Adrian Muniz. Noah Perez. Zaira Sanchez. Brock Andrew Tijerina.
Zamarin or Zamarun?
Yasmin Zamarun. Kelly McCafferty.
Nubia Sprodling.
Nubia Sprodling. Robert Hunt II. Isabel Lopez. Jordan Strickland. Christopher Toma. Madison Davis.
Miranda.
Miranda Lem. Macy Maxson. Miranda Ornelas. Lauren Payan. Matthew Martinez. Alex Natera. Justin Glass. Alexandra Alvarez.
Rashida
Rosales.
Bias.
Janet Bias. Joanna Cadena. Mata. Cinderella Ballum. Miranda Carrasco. Marisa Castillo. Amanda Chavarria. Fatima Masaba Diawara. Megan Gregory. Raven Luna. Siley McReynolds. Marisa Muniz. Hope Wynn. Odieli Titilayo. Eric Peña. Kayla Ramirez. Nayeli Ramirez. Alexia Rodriguez. Megan Rodriguez.
Joshua.
Josue Sanchez. America Serrano. Elizabeth Skelton. Aaron Valeriano. Jessica Campos Andrade.
Gabriela
Jackson. Yaretzi Quiroz Ramirez. Catarino Carrillo. Britton Freetag. Maximilian Montes Ledbetter. Silvia Alemán.
Lisbeth
Guillén.
Ryan.
Amanda Rael. Itzel Aguilar. Brittany Holly. Arsha Word. James Kerr.
Shirlene
Barrera.
Aminat Bakari.
Aminat Bakari. Esmeralda Chavez. Fernanda Fernandez. Devorick Gibson. Noemia Gutierrez. Skylar Jordan. Chloe Lara. Brittany Lott. Adebisi Imade. Cassandra Lujan. Diani Madrid.
Obozi.
Joyce Obozi. Kara Valdez. Roberto Armendariz. Misael Rosas Diaz. Jesse Villafranco. Tyler English. Britton Hill. Alejandro Alanis. Andres Aleman. Abigail Almanza. Brianna Ansules.
Giovanni
Coronado. Damara Dada. Brooklyn Dow. Reagan Dutton. Abigail Gallero. Zaya Goodley. Julia Hubbard. Andrea Iguado. Yaretzi Lozoya. Estefania Lujan. Hatsiri Jimena Martinez Flores. Anaya Mayberry. Fátima Moreno. Jordan Oliver. Go. Armando Pantoja Gutierrez.
Deshaya Patterson.
Deshaya Patterson.
I messed up.
Abby Ramos. Daniela Rodriguez. Abigail Rubio. Tessa Sauceda. Jacob Sinclair. Ella Thomas. Belen Toscano.
Aaliyah
Valdez. Juliana Wilder.
Aiden Cobos.
Aiden Cobos. Stephanie Hernandez. Rachel Hopkins. Rebecca Loya. Rylan Nunez. Janelli Peña. Katie Phelps. Salgado. Catherine Corley.
We know that in order to be a successful student and to get to this point, it takes the support of a great many people, especially friends and family. So I'm going to take just a moment to thank everyone in the audience tonight, mothers, fathers, brothers, sisters, husbands, sons, daughters, grandparents, family, friends, the list goes on and on and on. As Kit said earlier, no one gets to this point alone. So I want to say thank you to everyone who has supported these candidates tonight. I want to say thank you to those who've shown love and support. And I want all of you candidates to join me in thanking all of the folks here in the auditorium for their love and their support. At the conclusion of the ceremony, I'll ask all of now candidates, soon to be graduates, to remain seated until the ushers lead you off of the floor. Once you're at the upper level, we will invite you to stay, have pictures with families at our photo spot hosted by the Midland College Alumni Association, located at door 2. I mentioned at the onset of this ceremony that this was our first fall commencement. Some of you are first-time graduates. This is my first fall commencement, so we're going to do another first. I'm going to ask the candidates to please rise. And we're going to have a first Midland College commencement selfie. I've been told I'm really bad at this, so you guys are going to have to show some energy for a minute longer than normal, because it'll take me a second. But here we go. You guys ready? All right, a little energy. All right. Thanks for indulging me. Those of you who have taken your own selfies, I want to invite you to post those to the socials, the Tag Midland College, hashtag Midland College Commencement Fall 2023. And look for this. Hopefully I don't embarrass myself or you in the process. And now, what we've all come to celebrate. By the powers vested in me by the state of Texas and the Midland College Board of Trustees, it gives me great pleasure to present the candidates for baccalaureate degree, associate degree, and certificates from Midland College in their respective programs. Graduates, please move your tassels from the right side to the left side. Ladies and gentlemen, I present you the Midland College December 2023 graduates.